Okay, traders, Brian with SixFigureTrader.com, and our long-anticipated, long-awaited trend down day has arrived. Let's take a look here at the daily chart of the E-mini, and you can see here that this long-anticipated red bar day, we have been waiting for this day for a number of weeks, and it is finally here. It's the first one we've had since November. So, good day to be trading the short side, and want to show you a little bit about how I handled this day today. The S&P you see here on the 5-minute chart, let me get rid of these for you, and you can see the two moving averages I follow here, the blue line and the red line, are the moving averages that I have given to you, and I've given you this free indicator here in my free e-course. So you guys should have those indicators. If not, check out the blog. There's a instructional there. It shows you how to do it, or it's a YouTube video. So the way these moving averages work is on days like today when we're trending, you will never see the market penetrate. As long as the trend remains intact, you will never see the, well, I don't want to say never, but these moving averages provide very, very strong points of support and resistance. In this case, we have a trend down day today, so we're looking at resistance. And you can see here we've hit the moving average, we hit it here, we hit it up here, and again in this area, and then also more recently right here, and you can see that the price is being repelled. So as long as this trend remains intact, you know, these moving averages are going to be good points to you know, keep your stops, or I don't so much use them for entries unless there's some other indication that we need to enter the market, but very helpful tools. And also, you know, if you're buying these dips, which you really shouldn't be, I have to admit, I did buy this dip here on a whim, only because I knew that I could use a tight stop, and I took a 1-point profit, and I took that 1-point profit on this moving average right here because I knew that it would provide some resistance. You can see that it did provide resistance on these few bars here. So yeah, great moving averages to use. Again, check out the video. On a longer time frame, we have we've done some damage today. You can see we're working on breaking a a 2-day low here. If we close below this, that's you know, it's not good news. If we close below this, it's bad news. And then beyond that, our next point we're looking to close below here is at 1265, and then of course the 1258. I think we probably will break below these levels here in the next few days. But even more important or more significant is resistance. And that is this hugely psychologically significant number of 1,300 on the S&P. I'm not quite sure what that corresponds to on the Dow, but 1,300 is a psychological barrier for the entire market. And I believe that's part of the reason we've repelled here. Also, want to update you on the box trade. So the box trade setup that I have gone in over in a, actually, you know what? I'll just do another video on that. Never mind. We'll talk about that in the next video. So 1,300, huge, huge resistance. If we get above it, probably won't stay above it very long. Probably won't close above it. But with today's move, I would say the odds are even higher that we'll never even see it. So here's what you have today with the S&P. As far as trading ideas today, what I did today, I got short. Actually, I got short last night, so I rode most of it down and then back up. I actually sold. What did I? I sold this right here and move my stop to break even, and then stopped out here, and then got short again up in here. But I was anticipating a much higher move before I would get short. So I didn't have my full position size on, but I was able to participate in some of this move. And I was taking the position off today on these dips, which also corresponded to negative 1,000 tick on the NYSE. So these are great high probability exits on trades when you're short to get out when the tick reads negative 1,000 or greater. You want to cover your position for day trading or even scalp trading, because these points will often provide resistance, short-term support, and sometimes long-term support and resistance. So that's what I did with these. And then also, I sent out an email update to my subscribers today and told them to get short on a 500 tick if we get a positive 500. We didn't quite get positive 500. I got 455 on mine, and that was right here. So it looks like that trade worked out pretty well. But we didn't quite get the entry signal. But that's how you treat days like today. You want to be trading the short side. You don't want to be buying the dips. You want to be covering your short position on the dips. And you want to be selling the rallies. Now, where we go for the rest of the day here, probably we're going to need to get some more down tick to make lower lows today. But I would say if we break above 84 here and we're able to stay above that, you know, for maybe 30 minutes or an hour or so, then there's a chance that we could rally into the close. There's a 500 tick right there. I'm actually going to sell that. So we'll sell 1282 right here. Yeah, let's see if I get a fill. Come on, fill me. I'm just going to pause the video. All right, so sorry about that. I had to just pause the video. So what we need to look for today, the rest of the day, is the close. If we can rally all of this decline that we've had today by the close, then I think we're in for higher highs. But there has been some damage done today, and the bears have their opportunity right now to take this market and drive it lower. So the close is going to be the tell-all. So hang in there, traders, and we will talk to you soon.